हाय
हाय।
लाइव है।
हाँ लाइव है। स्लाइड
नहीं हाय ओके सो आई थिंक होपफुली सम पीपल आर जॉइनिंग अस राइट नाउ। एंड आई थिंक टुडे इज अ वेरी शॉर्ट केस दैट आई हैव सेंट मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल। आई होप सम ऑफ देम हैव एनालाइज द केस।
Okay, very good evening to all the participants. I hope you all are enjoying the MM series. So I think let us begin with another interesting session today.
Thank you, Dr. Brati, for the introduction. So we are doing this after fairly, it looks as if we are doing this after like many, many weeks today. I don't know why.
Last session was very small, that's why.
I think you're very fond of the last session, I guess. Anyways, let's come to the talk for today. And let me open. Easy. Okay. Share. Okay. And I will do this. Is okay. Can you see the screen,
yes,
doctor?
Yes.
Okay. So sounds good. I think we are live, and welcome back to Materia Medica Series Reloaded. And I'm very excited to share some interesting ideas with you today again. It's a simple case, but interesting case. So I thought we could learn something out of this. And gradually some people are joining us all across. Okay. So maybe I can start the case. So it's a 25-year-old lady with a dry cough since 4 years. Has taken many, many remedies, maybe 10, 20 remedies in homeopathy before. Gets a lot of paroxysms of cough 5 to 6 times, always aggravated by eating solid food, spicy food, better by drinking liquid. There's a huge gland on the parotid which has started after marriage. Physicians have started with AKT. It's a tuberculosis of the lung. It's Cox lung. And on the CT scan, it shows the upper lobe is affected. The left side is more affected than the right side. And there's a lot of pain in the chest. And the patient has to hold the chest constantly and lie down supine constantly. So this is the chief complaint, and this is where they have come to see us. About the nature, she says that she likes to talk a lot. Very, very loquacious, means once she starts talking, she doesn't stop at all. And although she's also a little introvert, she says in her own words. Creative, but likes to do craft and all this kind of thing from waste things. Normally, she says she likes to stay alone, doesn't like being with too many people. Hobbies like traveling, dancing, etc. Anger, She says that she tries to keep quiet during anger, and she only talks to herself and tries to cry in front of the mirror when she gets very angry. She's very, very close to her father, and if anything happens to her father, it affects her a lot, and she's very, very sensitive about it. Effect of the problem on her. She says, I felt very low and felt very alone at home when she came to know that she had TB, tuberculosis, and a lot of cough and a lot of suffering. She says she used to cry and tell her partner, don't marry me, I'm sick. And that she felt very hurt. And she would keep crying and crying and crying and crying. That's about it. She gets dreams that her husband wants to have a child. But she says that she isn't ready for it. But there's no one to understand her, and that affects her a lot. She feels bad about it. There's a lot of fear of dogs, and especially that dogs will bite. And she's very scared of this dog bite and dog injury also. As a child, she was very quiet and used to talk with family members, but she was like a baby as a child and very, very childish in that way. Family history, nothing strong. Mother had thyroid issues also. What was the most stressful situation? It was a love marriage that she did, and she didn't want to hurt her family, as you know, in Indian culture, most of the conservative family, they cannot handle love marriage so easily. But the parents are now talking to the husband properly, and she was very sensitive to the idea that society shouldn't blame her father for this, whatever was happening. A lot of craving for pani puri and spicy food, and she likes to sleep on the left side, very thirsty, very unrefreshing sleep actually. Has taken many, many medicines: phosphorus, calibichromicum, belladone, iconite, corallium rubrum, coccus cacti. There is a whole list of medicines that she has taken before this. On the reports, it shows that there is a granuloma on the upper lobe, and it suggests Cox. So this is a situation in which she has come, very difficult situation, and they have a lot of hope on homeopathy, and that's when we are here to help. So many, many suggestions here. Dr. Birad, Shobha, Lenka, all are saying Lachesis. Muhammad Yasin says Aurum. Asiya says Tuberculinum. Let's see some other suggestions. Priya says Bromium. Muhammad Yasin says Aurum Metallicum. Phosphorus tuberculinum. Let's see any other suggestions. Calcarea carb, bacillinum, Picasso. Okay. Tudoral says Netramune. Shreyas, Naxomica, Bryonia, Kamala, Netramore, Elizabeth, Costico. How are you doing, Elizabeth? Vanilla says Metrorhinum. Naja or Metallicum, Lipidas, Stramonium. Okay. Lippy, but Stramonium doesn't match the physical symptoms. Meenakshi, Phosphorus. But Phosphorus he has already taken, no? I told you. Many, many medicines have been taken. Magatha, Pulsatilla. Okay. Simisifuga. Okay. So you want me to tell the case again? I'll tell you in short, okay? No problem. 25-year-old lady with dry cough since 4 years, paroxysms of cough 5 to 6 times, solid food causes cough, eating causes cough, AKT she has started, but still it's not reducing. The upper lobe is affected. There's a granuloma. It's a cox. After AKT, this cough has started more and more. So allopathic medicines are aggravating chest pains, has to handle the chest, very, very talkative, creative, likes to do very, very creative thing, can't stay alone at all. Likes likes traveling, dancing, gets very angry and talks to herself in anger, very close to father, very sensitive, something happens to her. Felt very, very low when being alone and used to cry and would tell her partner, don't marry me, and would feel very, very sensitive. Dreams that husband wants a child and felt that no one understands her, feels very bad. Fear of dogs, and in childhood would feel like almost childlike, like a baby, not very decisive. Stressful situation was love marriage where the family was against and it was a tough time for her. She was sensitive that her family shouldn't be blamed by the other people. Craving for pani puri and spicy food. And yeah. And as you see in the reports, it was calcified granuloma of the apical segment. So what did I do? Any suggestions? It's a very straightforward case. Okay, let me show you what I did. So I just took the main rubrics in the case. Let's see what are the main rubrics. Okay. I don't know if you can see this. So cough after eating, loquacity, desire to travel, sympathetic, fear of dogs, and very important rubric for me, chest inflammation, lung pneumonia, upper apex. And if you put it, there is only a single remedy that comes up. What's the remedy? Hello? What the remedy? So you can very interestingly see the main remedy that comes up is tuberculinum. And she already is diagnosed of TB. So tuberculinum is a very interesting remedy for her. But the question is, which tuberculinum? Are you all with me? Which tuberculinum? So this is where we will today learn something very, very interesting. Okay. About. Let's see if I have the. Okay. My book. Let's see. Yeah. So we will today hopefully learn a little bit about tuberculin. I hope you have read this book of mine. If you don't have it, please order it. Materia Medica of Sarcodes and Nozodes with Therapeutic Index. And I've dedicated it to my teachers from Kolkata. This is National Institute of Homeopathy, where I spend a lot of my time. I've dedicated this book to West Bengal, actually, to Dr. Sarkar, L.M. Khan, Subhas Singh, and M.M. Dutta. And it's a very, very interesting book. There's lots to learn from this book. Dr. Sarkar has written in this, Dr. Gaurang is a true hybrid of his gurus, Dr. Sankaran and Dr. Vijay Vaishnav myself, which is reflected in his writings. Interesting, no? To read this. So let's study tuberculinum. Let's see. Let me open tuberculinum. Okay. So we'll try to learn a little bit about different tuberculinums today. Okay. No. Okay. Where are you? Huh. Okay. Lineup. Okay. So here we go. So first of all, we should know what are the different tuberculinums which are already there in homeopathy. Any idea? Can you think of which are the different tuberculinum in homeopathy we have? So let me put it here. There is a whole range of tuberculinum. There are almost, I put here, 26 different types of tuberculinum. Can you have a look? Tuberculinum, the tuberculinum that we use, which is prepared by Swan and Fink. Bacillinum, tuberculinum cox residual, cox lymph, tuberculinum aviary, tuberculum serum of Joseph, allergen of Joseph, bolion of Danes, dilat serum marmoric, tuberculinum bovinum, human tuberculum of Klebs, immunizing body of Spengler, so many of them. BCG, Bacillinum testicum, many tuberculinum. I will tell you a little bit about this. Bacillinum testicum, mainly used for very difficult cases of bedwetting in children. Just remember this much. Okay? So if you get tuberculinum, but the main symptoms is bedwetting in children, think about Bacillinum testicum. The remedy which I gave to our patient is the remedy Tuberculinum AVRA. It's a preparation which is prepared from chicken's tuberculosis. So when the tuberculosis happened in chicken, from there it was prepared, introduced by Dr. Cartier and from France. What are the symptoms? Let's have a look. Maybe I can show you this in Boric also. This is written in Boric also. Okay, let's see. Tuberculinum avis, Boric Materia Medica. Dekho kya likha hai. देखो क्या लिखा है ट्यूबरकुलाइनम फ्रॉम बर्ड्स एक्ट्स ऑन अपाइसेस ऑफ द लंग देखो कैन यू सी द एग्जैक्ट व्हाट वाज द अफेक्शन इन द लंग अपर लोब वाज अफेक्टेड सो यू हैव टू लर्न व्हिच लोब इज अफेक्टेड व्हिच लोब इज व्हिच रेमेडी इज बेटर अपर लोब एंटीमनी आर्स ट्यूबरकुलाइनम एविस लोअर लोब चेलिडोनियम राइट साइडेड लोअर लोब चेलिडोनियम लाइकोपोडियम लेफ्ट साइडेड अनदर रेमेडी मिडिल साइडेड कैल्केरिया कार्प आर्सेनिक. So you have to learn this kind of materia medica. Are you all with me? Are you getting an idea? Say yes. I think today people are busy watching news. The elections, the police arrest. I think that's what's more interesting suddenly. Anyways, so it has proved to be an important remedy in bronchitis similar to tuberculosis. Relieves debility, diminishes the cough, improves appetite, braces up whole organism. Acute bronchopulmonary disease of children. In many cases in children with recurrent cold and cough, when tuberculinum fails, I use AVRA. And finally, in today's times, in COVID times, post-COVID, or in cases where there is a recurrent cold and cough, you know, even post-COVID patients are getting recurrent cold, cough, wheezing. Very often we are giving the remedy Tuberculinum AVRA with beautiful results. 200 C1 dose, wait and watch. Okay? Learn this clinical materia medica. Learn this clinical knowledge. This is the real homeopathy. And very often post-COVID, there is a loss of strength, loss of appetite. Dekho. Everything is written in Boric, in Kent, in Farrington, in Nash, in Pathak. But we are trying to find it on some other channel. Cow. Okay. So Tuberculinum AVRA. Very important for post any kind of flu, post viral illness when cough and weakness remains, Tuberculinum AVRA. Rattling without expectoration, desire for meat, and recurrent infection in childhood or recurrent infection that has happened. Some more tuberculinums, huh? Tuberculinum Dennis. It's a very important remedy for especially for hydrogenoid concentration of people. Then Tuberculinum Residuum. This is very, very important for any kind of cases where there is tuberculomyosin, but there is a lot of joint complaints, especially where there is sclerosis and there is contraction problem, joints problem, chronic rheumatism, ankylosis, spondylitis. Think about it. Meenakshi Ratalpan, which repertory lobes of lung? Boric repertory. I made a small diagram of it. You will read about it in one of my new books. Tuberculinum marmoric, very important. Skinny children, low immune system. Tuberculinum cox, very important with tubercular miasm with thyroid pathology. Okay, cox lymph, very important for renal failure with tubercular myosin. So there are different types of tuberculinum. Please understand, different type of tuberculinums are there. Okay, more or less. So where did our case go? Kahan gaya? Tuberculinum. Okay, so I gave just tuberculinum AVRA 2 times a day for 2 days, then nothing after that, and just follow up after 40 days. I'm showing you, this is a follow up just after 40 days of medicine, and the cough and the pain reduced by 80%. Remarkable change. This patient was in one of the worst cases. It was like a subacute situation. She was coughing, emaciated, dull, depressed, just in front of me, just in 40 days, just one dose of tuberculinum AVRA for 2 days. Swelling has gone, chest pain has gone, and even the husband is saying a remarkable change. We have never seen anything like that before. This is homeopathy. So tuberculinum AVRA is what I wanted to talk to you today about, and to tell you that there are different types of tuberculinums, not one. and I want you to read this different types of tuberculinums from Clark Materia Medica. Clark se padho. Clark Dictionary Practical Materia Medica. Read all this. Bacillinum testicum, tuberculinum AVRA, all types of tuberculinum. Dekho, padho. Read from Clark Dictionary and email me what you learned. Will you email me today? Say yes. So gaye. And that's why this brings me to something very exciting that we are doing. I hope most of you have had a look at my website. And towards the November end, I am coming up with the first ever workshop online on nosodes, sarcodes, and bowel nosodes. This is something I'm very, very excited about. This is the first time I'm doing this. And there is a special Diwali offer. If any one of you will do a pre-booking before Diwali, you'll get a 50% off. You have to just email us, and the fees is 1,000 rupees after 50% off, and for international participants it's $25. If you are interested, you can either email me or message on this number. And what are the main things about the workshop? That it is around 6 hours of workshop total. Participant will be given access for 1 month. For 1 month, you can keep watching that webinar again and again. You will get to learn all different types of sarcode, nosode, bowel nosode in depth with case example and clinical tips. After every kind of topic, MCQ test will be taken, certificates will be given, and I will be doing a question answer session at the end of it. So this is something that we are very, very excited about. If you're interested, you have to get a, so you can get a 50% off for the participants. So I hope you are excited about this. Say yes. So this is what it is. This is my email ID, and I hope that some of you are able to read the books which I have written. These are my 2 books, Decoding Mental Rubrics and Materia Medica of Nosodes and Sarcodes. And my new books are also getting published very soon. And I really want all of you who are watching right now to join for my workshop. And this workshop is so exciting that I would really, really want all of you to join this. Your way of prescribing, especially in the follow-ups and chronic cases and intercurrents, will change. So what are the dates? It will be last week of November. So it will be uploaded around 24th of November. But if you want to join it, you have to pre-book it before 14th. So you'll get a 50% off. And you will get an access for 1 month. For 1 month, you can keep watching it again and again. So this is what it is. I hope you are excited enough for what this is. Well, dates for the workshop post 24th November. But I hope you got a little bit of idea about different types of tuberculinum. One of the very important one is tuberculinum aviary. Another very important is cox lymph. Bacillinum testicum. These are important, different. So I've spoken about all this in detail, and it will be very, very exciting. Purna Thij, can we take abandoned rubric? Yes, you can take. You will still get tuberculinum. Lot of importance of using nosodes and bowel nosodes and sarcode. Ambari, can you tell us the timing? You can decide the timing. It will be uploaded on the website. You can decide you want to watch it in day, you want to watch it at night, you can do whatever you want. So yeah, that's it from me today, and I hope that I get to see all of you for the webinar series which we are doing, and very, very excited for it. We are working round the clock for this webinar. We are working round the clock for my new book that is coming up called as Art of Repertorization, and it's crazy, absolutely crazy. So I'm very excited, and I want to genuinely invite you, all of you, to attend this session, and please pre-book it, because you're going to get a 50% off. Pre-book it, the first 200 people, because already almost more than 100 people have emailed. So if you are interested, you'll have to write to us so you can book it. And that's about it from me today. Thank you so much, and take care of yourself. See you later.
Okay. So I think that was another short and sweet talk by Dr. Gaurang. So if anyone of you is interested for the nosodes and sarcodes module, you can email it to him, and some of you have already written it to me on WhatsApp, so I'll send the registration details to you. So please register yourself as soon as possible, and also if you have not read the book Nosodes and Sarcodes and Decoding Mental Rubrics yet, please book your copy soon, and I think definitely it will help you in your difficult cases where you are not getting results or where you are stuck in some case. So a different kind of approach. So when you learn it from the books, from the cases, from the experience, you will be able to apply it in your practice. So that's all from today's session. See you all next Thursday with another interesting session of MM series. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.